good afternoon and good evening, everybody, depending on what time zone you're in. Thank you so much for your interest in my recital and holiday special and taking the time to tune in and listen. This has been a challenging year with the fact that we've gotten so used to doing almost everything online and looking at video screens and listening through Zoom and other forums. So I really appreciate you're here and spending your evening or afternoon listening to my recital. Before I go any further, I'd like to give some birthday shout outs. First to my Aunt Laura in Rhinebeck, Iowa. She had her birthday yesterday. And my housemate and friend Aaron, who you'll see later in the recital, has his birthday tomorrow. My Aunt Jeannie is on the 25th. My friend Shelley is on the 25th. My friend Rod is on the 23rd. Mel on the 23rd. And my friend Suzanne, whose birthday I forgot just a few days ago. So if she is tuning in, happy birthday belated to you, Suzanne. As you're all well aware, this year for anybody in the performing arts or anybody who's in food service or any kind of job that relies on working frequently with the public, our livelihoods have been really curtailed and it's been precarious at best here and there. So luckily I appreciate and very thankful I live with two wonderful housemates. But back to the issues of this year, it's been nearly impossible to do any performing. And so I'm deeply humbled to already have received several donations from friends and family and colleagues, students, former students, parents of students. It's deeply, deeply appreciated and something I'll never forget. So anyway, moving into the recital now, the first piece I'm gonna play is by a living composer. Her name is Juri Seo. First name is spelled J-U-R-I, last name is S-E-O. She is the composer in residence at Princeton University, and this suite for solo cello was written in 2018. I found out I'm the third cellist to have learned it and being performing it. So I became aware of this piece through my mother. She is an usher at the Blue Dorn Gallagher Performing Arts Center in Cedar Falls, Iowa. She's been an usher there since they opened 20 years ago. Anytime a classical or instrumental group comes through, she makes sure to get a recording and send it to me, which of course I always appreciate. And about a year and 3 months ago, the Argus String Quartet, A-R-G-U-S, Argus String Quartet, performed at the Blue Dorn Center. And my mom afterwards got a CD, and it happened to be the Argus Quartet playing music of Juri Seo. And on it was also this suite for solo cello. From the moment I heard it, I wanted to learn it. It's such a compelling piece. There's so much nuance, variety of timbre, especially just the different qualities of sound. And the instrument's tuning is, instead of A, D, G, C, it's A, D, G, B. So that creates already an unusual sort of sound for the instrument. The next thing about it too is that one of the movements uses a metal mute, which I have never had to use for any piece. And just a word about that second movement. I might have to restart it because a metal mute, very unusual, sometimes it shakes out of place. So I may have to stop and reset this. So this is my first time performing this piece too. So it's a good test run and I hope you guys enjoy it. It's in 5 movements, and without further ado, I'll get started and hope you enjoyed this piece. And yes, one last thing. Sheba, I think you're going to have to leave. My dog is sitting over here, and I know as lovely as she is, she's going to be making her sound. So come on, dog. Let's go. Come on. Come on, Rue.
Sheba.
Come on, Doe.
Sheba. Come on, lady.
All right. Many of you know I'm very attached to her, and she's probably even more attached to me. Without further ado, the solo cello suite of Juri Seo. Thank you.
Thank you.
thank you. Apologies again for the technical glitches that occurred during the piece, and apologies for potentially interrupting the flow of the tone of the piece. So I will be performing that piece again three times in the next few months. In a month from now, on the 28th of, a little over a month from now, 28th of January, I'll be playing this as part of a recital for the Philadelphia Virtual Music Festival. Not the exact same program, but this will be included. I'll likewise be playing it for a concert for Community Music School for a live stream recital for their Box Lunch series in February. And later in the spring or summer, I'm still slated to give a recital with a pianist. And this is the solo work that I'm going to play on it. So three more times in performing it, hopefully without the technical glitches between. So now, moving away, we're going to move into something more familiar that, you know, as it gets darker out here, I hope you guys are enjoying my beautiful work on the Christmas lights and these lovely trees. And the plastic is a little obscuring it here. I want to make a shout out about when we are very good at window plasticking here, but nobody is as good of a window plasticker as my beloved brother-in-law, Andy. He has it down to it's like a quantum level. You can't even see the plastic, and you flick it, and it sounds like a bass drum. It's exquisite. So we don't have quite his acumen, but we're getting there. So I'd like to invite my housemate and friends, Joseph and Aaron, in now to play a little holiday-themed music before we get back to solo cello stuff. So let's see, and I think Dog can stay for this one. How about you
go up there, Mule?
And I'd like to thank my housemates for helping me out with this recital and being technical support and such. And let's see, Coventry Carol, yes. Nice, beautiful instrumental here in the key of A minor. Okay, where is that? Yes, indeed.
Yeah, well done with that, Eric. Mm-hmm. That's a tough piece.
Thank you very much. They've been hearing me practice this for months, and
it's really grown on me.
Thank you. Well, do we have enough room here?
Yeah, how about you? I think we're
looks like Sheba's really, really ready for us. What do you say, Sheba?
Sheba.
You ready? Good girl.
Thank you.
nice one. And I forgot to do something and get out of my tuning.
No.
From the other piece. As like we were playing our Coventry Carol, I was terrified of hitting the C string. Like, oh my goodness, the harmony's so pure. My half step off. So that will make my life much easier for the rest of the recital to go back into normal tuning. Phase back into normal space time here. Oops. Moment, please. Thank you, Joseph. This tuning difference takes sometimes a moment to just really. It or does it speak for itself?
I think it speaks for itself.
All right, here we go.
Two, three.
Fun to play with these fine musicians and merry gentlemen, the way I say. So, okay, well, moving away from the ensemble music, next up is three melodic etudes for solo cello, not all by the same composer. They're each from a different time period, and an etude is a piece that's written as a technical study for an instrument. Usually it just focuses on one or two techniques. For cello, it could be something like double stops or bow patterns, string crossing techniques. So a lot of different variety of etudes, but some of them are also melodic. So I'm going to start first, and oh, it's time for someone to leave here. How about you go, dog? How about you go? Go on now. Come on. Get her going. I'd like to start off these etudes with etude of Pierre-Auguste Franchomme. He's a Romantic era French cellist, or was, a good friend of Frédéric Chopin. And I think Chopin had dedicated his cello sonata to Franchomme. So he wrote a huge amount of cello music, a lot of etudes, caprices, sonatas, and whatnot. And From his Caprices Opus 7, there's number 9 in B minor, has long been one of my favorites. It was also a favorite of a cello teacher named, one of my cello teachers named Charles Wendt, and I studied with him for 6 years. He was absolutely in love with this etude, and I love playing it. I haven't put it in a concert in many years. I hope you enjoy it. It's been fun getting to re-know this piece. So, Etude Caprice, number 9, Opus 7 of Franchomme. Thank you guys. One word too, before I play my next etude, you might hear a little fidgeting and noises in the background. That's my dog. As you know, I'm very attached to her, and if I leave her up in the room above me, she'll probably bark. And so my housemates are doing a very good job trying to placate her, I guess you could say. And you might hear her sometimes kind of, and just so you know, that's not me singing along, that's my dog. Shows you why it's a challenge sometimes to practice here at home. Okay, well, moving on, an etude next, or study, a caprice, whatever you'd like to say about these pieces, by Duport. He was a French cellist from the classical era, about 1749 to about 1810 or so. There are two Duports, or I think three. Oh my goodness, I'm drawing a blank. I don't have the Duport in front of me, but this is by Jean-Pierre Duport, I believe. It's study number 8, a slow melodic study that, again, one of my main teachers, Charles Wendt, and I went over this religiously. He loved this one. This was also a favorite of Tanya Lozinski Carey, whom I studied with at Meadowmount for 3 summers. And I think it was a lesson with her that I got finally to the point where I could draw my bow slow enough to actually be able to play it. And so very good points of advice from those teachers both. And so study number 8 by Duport. Joy to the World isn't really part of that etude, just so you know. There's, at the end, a small portion where the composer writes basically ad libitum. It's like a little cadenza at the end of that. So I, you know, in another season I might do something else, but why not throw in a little Christmas reference during the cadenza point in the etude? It's 'tis the season, I guess. And speaking of seasons, the final etude I'm going to play is one of my favorite things ever to play. It's called the October Waltz. So it's a couple months out of date and there's snow on the ground, I know, but it's nice and warm, or heartwarming. It's not warm like outside, you know, it's colder outside. But it's really, really reminds me so much of the time when I first played it. I think it was like the fall of seventh grade. So it would have been about 30 years ago. And it reminds me so much of my old neighborhood I grew up in, and especially raking leaves and raking up the garden and burning it all at the end of the seasons, like mid-November or so. So this one just brings to mind my neighbors I grew up next to, and the look of our neighborhood on a nice fall night, and the smell of the leaves burning, and, you know, nice heartwarming Kodak moments here. Nice fuzzy, warm memories. October Waltz by Aaron Minsky, a living American composer, has written tons of stuff for various instruments, and this is part of his 10 American cello etudes published in the mid-80s. Before I play it, one last thing I got to say, and I'm really interested if you guys want to text me or contact me afterwards. I swear the composer is referencing an 80s hard rock ballad in the middle, so I will be really impressed if you can spot it or pick it out. I also can't help but get a big grin on my face at that moment. So I'm hoping you guys catch what that song is. Think 84, 85 power pop hard rock ballad. Hope you get it. Thank you. Yes. Thank you, everybody. And as I retune again, which I should have done before my etudes, if you would like to make a donation, you can Venmo me. It's @coineric, or use my PayPal, Eric Coin, or mail a check here to our house, 407 Glen Echo Road. That's G-L-E-N and then Echo, E-C-H-O, Glen Echo Road, Philadelphia, PA, 19119. And I, before the recital, I got a nice, wonderful donation from my sister and brother-in-law. Thank you very much. Think about you guys and the kids every single day, so I'm glad that you guys are tuning in. And let me double-check my tuning again. That's a challenge in a recital when you have two different tunings is going into original tuning and keep it in tune. And you know what? I think it's time I invite my housemates back for a little more Christmas charm. And of course, Sheba, come on and sit on the Davenport here. Sheba, come over and sit on the Davenport. Here we go. Good girl. Okay, we are going to move back into some Christmas and holidays music, you guys. So, welcoming back Mr. Aaron Beagle-Eisen and Mr. Joseph Arnold. And here we go. This is a familiar one from the British Isles. Yes, indeed. Sleeves are green. Yes, just like I hope you. I'm not sure if it's coming over so well through the visual so well. But speaking of green, here behind me, my lovely makeshift little gather sign that I made. It's a nice, touching little sign that I always enjoy seeing at friends' houses. Yep. Okay, the cello is in tune, and we don't have our cue to play until Sheba says we can play, and Joseph is getting our microphone. Thank you again for tuning in, you guys. This means the world to me. There were two different recitals I was supposed to play this fall, one in September and one in October, and wonderful to finally get a chance to do some performing instead of keeping on postponing them, so... I think we're ready. Sheba, are we ready? Looks like it. All right, we have the cue.
1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you.
so beautiful. It just really warms your heart, doesn't it? Okay, and speaking of warming your heart, we can't do holidays without some vocal music thrown in. So Aaron, Mr. Beagleizen, is going to indulge us with some lovely, lovely music of Irving Berlin that, you know, this is one that everyone can agree on is just really, really sends you. It's just so beautiful. So fun. Okay, here we go. So much fun singing that, and Sheba even returned to join in along. Sheba, why don't you sing along? Okay, well, moving along then, you guys, we'll move back to some solo cello music, something that is familiar to many, and if it's your first time hearing this piece, I envy you, because it's such a great piece, and one of my favorites to play. The Solo Cello Suite Number 1 in G Major of Bach. This is a piece, too, that I've been playing for, let's see, with the microphone, playing for most of my life now, and might be the piece I've performed the most as well. I'm thinking, how is this for the microphone?
Oh, yes.
Okay. Just a little bit of technical thing here, and go, dog, go. You're going to have to go. You're going to have to go, dog.
Come on.
Go on now. Go on. Get.
Come here, babe.
Get, dog. Okay. And just in case you have to corral her and rein her in, here is her leash.
Thank you.
Okay. The Suite Number 1 of Bach. It's in 6 movements. And without further ado, off we go through the journey of this wonderful piece. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Take a bow. Thank you, everybody. Before we conclude this evening, I'd like to just point out something. I hope, I don't know if this person is listening. I haven't checked the list, but this year, I got a new bridge for my cello this summer from Christopher Germain. He's a luthier here in Philadelphia down in Center City, and he made me a new bridge, and the cello, this cello I've had for 19 years, never sounded as good as with this bridge. So over audio, you know, over the Zoom, I'm sorry, Twitch TV and microphone, it might be different, but in person, those of whom know me and students of mine immediately heard the difference. So I want to just give him a big shout out for how wonderful of a job he did with this bridge and some work he did on my cello last year in 2019. So I'd like to invite the gentleman back so we can do a wrap-up song. And again, I want to just say for the another time, thank you so much for listening, you guys. It means the world to me and to my housemates. Their support too and assistance means the world to me. And Sheba is back, I see. So Sheba, holiday cheer from you, Rue. Good girl, good girl. Okay, well, why don't we get this set up? And a familiar, cozy Christmas piece, our Christmas song to end with. This is one that might possibly be my favorite. It always brings a tear to my eye. Well, not always, but it might be my favorite heartwarming Christmas piece. Christmas song. Okay. Should we tune
briefly?
Yes. Okay, good.
One, two, three.
Yeah.
Oh, I could play that one four or five times.
There you go. Yay!
Yay! Wonderful. Thank you, you merry gentlemen.
Indeed.
Thank you very much for your friendship support and being wonderful housemates and reining in Sheba. You know, she needs a lot of work and attention and understanding. So,
and where can people give you money for this concert, Eric?
The donations on Venmo at Coin Eric on Venmo or PayPal.
One E, Coin Eric.
Yes, C O Y N E R I C on PayPal, Coin or Eric Coin. I'm one person on there. Or mail a check here to 407 Glen Echo Road, G L E N, and then Echo, E C H O, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 19119. So thank you so much for your generosity, for your support, family, friends, students, students' parents, colleagues, people that I've invited by my housemates. It means the world to us as we wrap up a difficult and unusual year. So how about we say one last time to everybody, happy holidays!
Happy holidays!
Bah, humbug!
Thank you, everybody. Have a wonderful evening, and we'll enjoy our Christmas lights and our beautiful snow this evening.
All right. Good night.
Good night,
everyone.